Team Exotic.
And I'm Samurai.
And I'm 50 Cent, we're the creators of Fastener, the universal intermodal container mounting system. The intermodal transportation system was created to enhance the movement of freight by using containers. Containers are large, universal metal boxes that house the freight inside. It can be loaded onto different modes of transportation, such as planes, trains, trucks, and ships, all without ever actually touching the freight that is housed inside. Now, with large shipping companies promising increasingly faster shipping times, there's a very high demand for efficiency at a low cost. Specifically with the loading and unloading processes that have been adopted by most freight yards. Currently, it can take up to days for a full train to completely cycle through its containers. The full process looks like this. A train that pulls into a freight yard has to wait for an open lift. The open lift can't take it off until there is a hostler with a matching chassis. This process takes a ton of time and is extremely inefficient, and in this industry, the time is money.
Our solution for this is our product, Fastener. Fastener is it's a universal intermodal container mounting system. It's a device that can be added to a chassis or a rail flat car. A rail flat car or a chassis that equipped with our product will efficiently cycle through containers more efficiently. It uses thanks to the airborne mounting system. Here's an illustration of the airborne mounting system. As you can see here, where we can add it to the container, and it can easily shift to any transportation mode. The fastener increases the efficiency of the transition between rail and road transportation modes. Thanks to the universalization of the containers mounting systems.
Now, within our industry, there are a couple trends that they are focusing on. Companies are focusing on investments in railway expansion to get to smaller towns and facilities that have not been reachable by train yet. Sustainability, they want to be able to move things in a greener method, more environmentally friendly, and they want to do that in a cost-effective way. Another thing that they're focused on is information technology. So they want to be able to give you up-to-date information on exactly where your products are, how long it'll take to get to you, how long that they'll still be in transition, when they'll be moved, all the information that a customer could need. Another thing that they're concentrating on is intermodal transportation has increased to become more sophisticated and timely. So they want to be able to, such as the information technology, to give you more information and do it in a timely manner. They want to be able to move things more quickly and keep exact track of where those things are at the moment and be able to relay those to customers in real time. Another thing is that railway companies are researching efficiency in intermodal transportation. So in intermodal transportation, being able to move the product from a plane to a train to a trailer or back to a train quickly and be able to give that information efficiently is a big concentration, and the intermodal transportation also helps to save money by not having to touch a product. It saves time, so in turn, by saving money and saving time, they also are more cost productive, so they help to save even more money by combining those two. Now, our opportunity size would be every train company. Right now, we can just give examples of the top three. So Union Pacific, BNSF, and CSX all do over $44 billion in the shipping industry. Union Pacific right now has $3.7 million worth of services in intermodal transportation. BNSF has 25 intermodal stations that are dedicated just to intermodal transportation. CSX has 7,500 intermodal cars that are dedicated to just the service. So that shows how big of a concentration this actually is within the train companies. Now, our value would be decreasing the varying times of loading and standardizing the times. So instead of them having to deal with different companies, having different people and different modes of transportation, we would be able to standardize all those times and be, and they would be able to give a solid 5 or 10 minutes instead of 15 or 20 minutes for each trailer. And over a 100-car train, those will add up to a lot of time saved and a lot of money saved for the company. So that time saving could dramatically increase their revenue.
Basically, the value added that our products add to the, an existing intermodal transportation system. We are eliminating the need for hustlers. We are eliminating the search for matching trailer. In addition to that, we're decreasing the labor too. So all those logistics can decrease the cost way much less, as Samurai said. 8 to 10 minutes maybe seems not that much, but in terms of a lot of containers, that's a huge in an industry that considers time as money.
For freight yards who rely on adaptability and precision to get containers from point A to point B, faster is efficient yet cost-effective advancement to the current loading and unloading procedures used in rail yards. With high demand for efficiency, rail yards using Faster will save time and money, and it will ultimately pay for itself.
Now, in conclusion, Warren Buffett bought the remaining shares of BNSF because he's seen the value of train companies and shipping in the future. He knew that this would be a great investment for the companies because he can see that there is value in shipping containers, being able to ship larger or more customized loads to consumers without having to deal with the trailers or other shipping methods and being able to standardize those things and move it in a more efficient way. Intermodal transportation wasn't one of his main focuses, but with our improvements such as the fastener, this will increase the investment that he's already made.
All right.